Welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, I want to talk about initializer list constructors. For some of you, this might be a little bit mysterious, but let's go ahead and talk about some of these differences to make sure we understand what's going on here. I'm going to start by creating a vector. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains, and I wanted to let you know that I do personally use CLion in my work. I find the refactoring tools to be particularly valuable. The safe delete feature has saved me a ton of time when I've been doing refactoring on large projects. I can get analysis of my compile time checks and see when something is wrong or fails to compile right here in my IDE. So be sure to check out the links in the video description for a discount code and more information about how you can check out CLion. Now, depending on your level of experience with C++, you may or may not be able to immediately tell what is happening here. But I am calling the constructor for vector that takes two integral types, and technically it takes a size t and an int. I have set this up so that we can actually see what the container is that we have created, and we should get printed output from libformat here. As you can see, I have created a container with three integers of the value 4. This is equivalent to as if I had explicitly put int here, but I was using class template argument deduction here to let vector automatically deduce that I wanted a container of integers. Arguably, this should not compile. Why? Because it relies on an implicit conversion. This is a confusing constructor. Very few people understand what it does. And realistically, the first parameter thing is actually an unsigned size type. It's a UZ in C++ 23 land. So this would be the actual correct way for this to compile. But of course, our language has implicit conversions. You may or may not have heard me complain about that before. Let's go back to this. Now we have created three integers of the value 4. And if we were to change this to braces, we are now going to get a vector of the integers 3 and 4, not a vector of 3 4s. As we can see here, we have 3 and 4 printed from our container. This is exactly equivalent to as if I had put these braces inside of a parenthesized call to the constructor. And this is also going to print 3, 4. So we're calling two very different constructors in this case. Now let's go ahead and create our own container type of some sort. I like to use S because it is poorly named and it makes you think about better naming when you work on your own code. Let's walk through all of the various ways that this might be confusing. My new type S, it basically works like a pair. It's a pair of integers. I have put 3 and 4 in here, and this compiles as of C++ 20. I'm allowed to do this. In C++ 11, 14, 17, before that, I could have done it like this. In either case, I am calling no constructor. I am directly initializing the members of this thing with the values 3 and 4. This is no longer going to compile because I'm now trying to directly initialize just two members instead of three, and I have warnings as errors enabled, as you should have with your code so that you catch these really bad logic errors in your code. But it is possible for me to directly initialize all of the members again. And I should be able to do this with either parentheses or braces, again, because of those C++ 20 rule changes. Let's go ahead and add the constructor so we can reason more about this. Now, because I have added a constructor, I am no longer able to do this direct initialization. If I give any constructor at all, then I am calling the constructor. I'm going to use my member initializer list to initialize the members A and B here with the parameters that were passed in. As you can see, my data has not been initialized with anything. I did not give it any initial value here in the member initializer list. This code is going to do exactly the same thing, regardless of whether I am using braces or parentheses. In this case, I'm using braced initialization, but I have a constructor. I am not doing direct initialization. I am now calling that constructor that takes two integers, and I have the exact same result. I'm going to add another constructor. This one is going to take an initializer list of integers. And in this case, I am going to initialize my data object with the data parameter. Now, as you can see, when I am calling the braced constructor here, I am now calling the constructor that takes this special initializer list parameter. When the compiler sees an initializer list type in the constructor, it knows that it can call that constructor when it's doing braced initialization. And you see 0034 over here. If I go back to parentheses, on the other hand, then it is going to go back to calling this constructor that takes two integral values. You can see now A and B are equal to 3 and 4, and the data member does not been initialized with any data. It is default initialized with nothing. Let's get rid of this increasingly incorrect comment, and we will say here, I personally think this syntax should have been required. This is very clear to everyone what exactly is happening. Interestingly though, we can see that I am actually, very briefly, we actually saw that error. I have a read of an uninitialized value here. Let's go ahead and make sure that these are initialized. So these are initialized in every case now. But this is the syntax that I believe should have been required. I am creating an initializer list. That is what the thing between the braces is. So it's very obvious that I'm calling the constructor that takes an initializer list. So just so you know, this is what is happening. When you see these braces and you do initialization, it's not immediately obvious whether or not it's going to call an initializer list constructor or it's going to call a regular constructor. It would have been possible for our tools or our compiler to have forced us to do this version so that it was very clear exactly what was happening. Well, anyhow, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope this was interesting. Be sure to subscribe. Be sure to come to one of my classes where I can dig into more of these things with you and your fellow coworkers.